Very good morning, friends. In today's module, we would be discussing on it is the 10th module and of the course Analog Electronics. And we are discussing the module 1. And in module 1, our focus of discussion would be on small signal operations and models. Okay. And this is with relevance to the MOSFETs that we will be discussing. Okay, in part A, we had discussed about the small signal operations and models for the BJTs. And in today's session, we will be discussing on the small signal operations and models for the MOSFETs. Okay, and so in this session, the learning objective would be biasing in MOS amplifier circuits. We will also see the current in the signal current in brain and the small signal voltage gain. Okay, so this will be so by the end of the session, you will be able to understand the different biasing approaches, and you will also have an understanding on how we calculate the drain current and the small signal voltage. Okay, so first let's come to what are the different approaches for biasing in case of your MOS circuits or the MOSFET circuits. Okay, biasing in we already are familiar with the term biasing, where we are trying to create the circuit to establish the desired DC voltage or a current for the operation of the amplifier. As we know here, the MOSFETs can also be used for switching operation as well as amplification operation, and therefore our focus of discussion is for the amplification operation, and so where biasing plays a very important role. Okay, so that your operating points get fixed and therefore the transistor remains in the linear region of operation, so that the signal amplification happens. Okay, so creating the circuit to establish the desired DC voltage and current for the operation is nothing but biasing in MOSFETs. And DC operating point or the bias operating point is characterized here. Okay, in case of your MOSFET device, it is characterized by the DC drain current, that is ID, and by a DC drain to source voltage, that is VDS. So some of the approaches for biasing your MOSFET circuit is we have four different approaches for biasing your MOS circuits. One is biasing by fixing the VGS. Okay, the first method is biasing by fixing the VGS, that is voltage across gain to source, and then we have biasing by fixing the gate voltage and connecting a resistance in the source. And the third method is biasing using the drain to gate feedback resistor. Okay, and the fourth approach is biasing using a constant current source. Okay, so these are the different approaches in which you can bias the MOS amplifier circuit. Okay. So let's see each one of them, how you achieve the bias using these approaches. So let's first discuss on biasing by fixing the VGS. Okay, so in this method, you first fix its gate to source. Okay, first we will fix the transistor's gate to source voltage VGS to a value required to provide the desired drain current or ID. Okay, in abbreviation, drain current is abbreviated as I capital D. And then this voltage value can be derived from the power supply voltage VDD through the use of an appropriate voltage divider circuit. Okay, and alternatively, it can also be derived from another suitable reference voltage that might be available in the system. But biasing by fixing VGS is not a good technique. Okay, so in case of biasing by fixing VGS, the most I would like to say that it is most straightforward to bias a MOSFET by fixing its gate to source voltage to value that is required to provide the desired drain current. And as the gate current is zero, it can be, and since you are using the suitable, the voltage divider circuit, your gate voltage can be calculated using VDD into R2 by R1 by R1 plus R2, or VG is equal to VGS plus ID RS. Okay, so let me show you the circuit. Okay, so biasing here, so where this is the voltage divider. So this RG is nothing but R2 divided by R1 plus R2. Okay, and then you have the diode resistance. So VG will be equal to, VG is equal to VGS plus ID into RD. Okay, the drain current. So so RG can be it can be say you can use two, this threshold RG can be split into two voltage divider resistors, R1, RG1 and RG2, and it can be so selected that it is in the range of mega ohms, and that allows the MOSFET to prevent a large input resistance to the signal source that may be connected to the gate through a coupling capacitor. And again, the resistance RD is selected to be large as possible to obtain a high gain, but again small enough to obtain to allow the desired signal swing at the drain while keeping the MOSFET in the saturation at all times. And as I said, and when the MOSFET device is changed, even using the smaller same suppliers, okay, even using the small same suppliers, this method can result in a large variability in the value of ID. So devices 1 and 2 represent extreme, here you are seeing, okay, device 1 and 2 extreme represents extremes among units of the same time, okay, and we also know that the drain current ID is given by half kn dash W by L into VGS minus VT whole square, and we also know that kn dash is equal to mu n into epsilon ox by tox, which is equal to mu n cox. So you can write ID as mu n ca, half of mu n cox W by L VGS minus VT whole square. We also saw this derivation, and the values of the threshold voltage VT, and the oxide capacitance of COX and the W by L vary widely among devices, and we have seen the typical ranges of all these values in the previous session. Okay, and also the voltage gain. Okay, when you are using the MOSFET as an amplifier, the voltage gain VD is equal to VDD minus IDRD. So I substituting for ID here, you can rewrite the expression as VDS is equal to VD is equal to VDD minus 1 by 2 KN RD VGS minus VT whole square, right? And if we observe the characteristics of the MOSFET amplifier, we observe that VGS is less than VT, and the transistor is in cutoff region. Okay, and ID is almost equal to zero, and VDS is equal to VDD. And as VGS exceeds VT, the transistor turns on and VDS decreases. However, since VDS is still high, the MOSFET will be operating in saturation region or in the active region. And again, this continues as VGS is increased until the value of VGS is reached that results in a VDS becoming lower than VGS. by VT volts. So for VGS greater than, if you observe at point B, okay, greater than point B, the transistor will operate in the it will operate in the triode region. Okay, so this part of the curve. Okay, so it's operating in the triode region where you can see that VGS is greater. Is as VGS increases. Okay, it is moving on to the triode region. So the obviously we can know that this is obviously a nonlinear relationship. Okay, so because VDS is equal to VDD minus half of KN RD into VGS minus VT whole square. And linear means almost amplification can be obtained by using the technique of biasing the MOSFET. But considering biasing, however, it is useful to determine the coordinate of the point B, which is not at the boundary between the saturation and the triode region. Okay, and these can be obtained by substituting VGS. Okay, so if you observe, substituting VGS as so if you see here, we substituting VGS as VGSB is equal to VT that is equal to root of 2 times KN RD VDD plus 1 minus 1 by KN RD. Okay, and at point B can be alternatively characterized by the overdrive voltage, and therefore VDS is approximately equal to VOV. Okay, and hence VCE is equal to VCC minus RC into IS e power VBE divided by VT, which is very similar to that of the BJT transistors. Okay, and then if we also observe here at point Q, okay, so the point Q is known as the bias point or the DC operating point, right? Here. So this is called as the bias point or the DC operating point. And also the since Q at Q, the signal component is since the signal component is present, it is also known as the quiescent point, which is the origin of the symbol of Q. Okay, and the signal to be amplified, that is VGS, a function which is a function of time here, is superimposed on the bias. Okay, this is superimposed on the bias voltage VGS. Okay, and so that the total instantaneous value of VGS now becomes VGS of T is equal to, okay, VGS plus VGS of T is equal to, so which is a function of time, right? So VGS of T is equal to VGS plus VGS of T, okay? And so the resulting VDS can be obtained by substituting for the VGS of T. And if you graphically, we can also use the voltage obtain the VDS at point by point, you can obtain, okay? And then in case of VGS being the triangular wave of a small amplitude, if you observe, okay, the amplitude of VGS is small enough to restrict the excursion of instantaneous operating point to a short, almost a linear segment of the VTC around the bias point Q. And the shorter the segment, the greater the linearity achieved, and closer to an ideal triangular wave, the signal component at the output VDS, okay? And this is the essence of obtaining the linear amplification. Okay, so you can see the curve is linear here, and therefore it is So this is the essence for obtaining the linear amplification for the nonlinear MOSFETs. Okay, and again, if this happens at the negative peaks of the VGS, the transistor will go to the cutoff, or for the portion of cycle, and positive peaks of VDS will be clipped off. And if this again occurs at the positive peaks of VGS, the transistor will enter the triode region for a portion of the cycle, and the negative peaks of VDS will be flattened. Okay, and it follows and therefore the selection of the bias point Q can have a profound effect on maximum allowable amplitude of VDS, referred to as the allowable signal swing at the output. Okay. And hence you can obtain the VDS as AV into VGS, okay, the gain or the amplification. And then we will move on to the small signal voltage gain. So in case of your MOSFET, if the input signal VGS is kept small, the corresponding signal at the output VDS will be nearly proportional to VGS with the constant of proportionality being the slope of the almost linear segment of the VTC around Q. Okay, that is the transistor characteristics, voltage transistor characteristics around Q. And this is the voltage gain of the amplifier, and its value can be determined by evaluating the slope of the tangent to the VTC at the bias point Q. Okay, so this is the tangent that we are talking of. Okay, and then so your AV will be equal to, or considering the MOSFET amplifier, if the input signal VGS is kept small and the corresponding signal, what I said, okay, corresponding signal at the output VDS will be nearly proportional to VGS. Okay, and so your AV will be equal to dVDS by dVGS. Okay, for VG small cap, this is small V, represented by small V. Okay, so VGS is equal to capital VGS. So your AV will be equal to minus of, okay, say you can also write it as KN VGS minus VTRD, which can also be written as minus KN VOV, as the difference of this can be written as VOV. Okay, so it is minus KN VOV RD. Okay, so so from this we can make, if we observe the expression and also the characteristic curve, we can deduce our conclusion that the gain is negative, which signifies that the amplifier is inverting, and also there is a 180 degree phase shift between the input and the output. So this inversion obvious, okay, and the gain is proportional to the load resistance RD to the transistor transconductance parameter. Okay, that is here we are representing the transconductance characteristics by KN, right? So the gain is proportional to the load resistance RD as well as the transconductance parameter KN, and also the third parameter is VOV. Okay, that is the overdrive voltage, and again another insight is that gain, so ID is equal to, and therefore your ID is equal to half of KN VOV whole square. So substituting the value of KN for this equation, okay, if we substitute the value of KN, you get AV is equal to ID RD divided by VOV divided by 2. Okay, so this is equal to, we say this is the gain. So if you observe this equation, the gain is simply a ratio of the DC voltage drop. Okay, it is the ratio of DC voltage drop across the load resistance RD. Okay, to V by 2. So it can be expressed in the alternate form as VDD minus VDS, okay, divided by VOV by RD, okay, or the maximum slope of the curve, okay, or the transistor characteristics occurs at the point B, okay. So this is the point B, okay, so it occurs at the point B. And therefore, the maximum gain magnitude can be written as AV, mod of AV, AV max, which is equal to, or it is obtained by biasing the transistor at the point B. So it is V, VD divided by VOV by 2. Okay, so we were, VOV is given by, or it can be calculated using VGS minus VT, right? And the result is only theoretical importance, since biasing that B would leave no room for a negative signal swing at the output. And again, the result is valuable as it provides an upper bound on the magnitude of the voltage gain achievable from the basic amplifier circuit. Okay, so here, so for modern CMOS technologies, VOV is usually no lower than about 0.2 volts. Okay, so now let's see the other method, that is biasing by fixing VG. Okay, so here fixing the DC voltage in case of biasing using, by fixing VG, what we do is fixing the DC voltage at the gate, VG, and connecting the resistance. Okay, we connect the resistance known as the degeneration resistance and act as a negative feedback and is in the source lead. And so VGS is equal to VGS plus RS into ID. So where ID, when ID increases, VGS will have to decrease as VG is constant. So this in turn results in a decrease in ID, and so a change in so if you see, this will result in a decreased drain current, and a change in that is opposite to that initially that we assume. And so RS works to keep your drain current as constant as possible. Okay, and then we have, the other method is by fixing up the VG and connecting the resistance in the source. Okay, so here if you see the degenerative resistor being used, okay, so we have the voltage divider circuit and the degenerative transistor. So so this is very similar to the as you are fixing the voltage gain, okay, in case of your gate voltage. Okay, so and then we will see the drain to gate feedback resistor. So here the large feedback resistance RG forces the DC voltage at the gate to be equal to that of the drain, and so VGS is equal to VDS, that is equal to VDD minus RD ID. So VDD is equal to VGS plus RD ID RD. And if ID increases, then VGS must decrease, and the decrease in VGS in turn causes a decrease in the drain current. So a change that is opposite in direction to the one originally assumed. So thus the negative feedback or the degeneration provided by RG works to keep the value of ID as constant as possible. Okay, and then biasing using a constant current source. So this so here in this case, RG is usually in mega ohms range. Okay, and it establishes a DC ground that the gate presents a large resistance to the input signal source. Okay, and that is the input signal source is again capacitively coupled to the gate, and the resistance RD here. Okay, so you can see RD here establishes an appropriate DC voltage at the drain to allow for the required output signal swing while ensuring that the transistor always remains in the saturation region. And this is the current mirror for which is used in integrated circuits. Okay, and then we have the width and length and the parameters of the transistor can be different. And again, we can choose W and L value freely. And in this circuit, we consider W and L for W bar L for both MOSFETs are the same. Okay, the both devices that you are considering. And so that the transistors are identical. So the gate source voltage are also the same. And then so your I reference is equal to half of KN W1 by L1 VGS minus VT whole square. And so your I is equal to half of KN W1 by L1 VGS minus VT whole square. So I reference, I by I reference is equal to W1 by L1 dot L1 by W1, which is equal to 1. So I is equal to I reference. Okay, so that's why it is the current mirror. This is the current mirror DC analysis. So designing how you're designing IRF is IRF is equal to VDD minus VGS plus VSS. So your I reference is equal to 1 minus, half of KN W1 by L1 VGS minus VT whole square. So it is often needed to find the value of R in order to achieve the desired I reference. Okay. So now let's see some problems in case of your MOSFET circuits. So the first problem is for a E MOSFET, determine the value of ID. If ID on is equal to 4 milliamp, VGS on is 6 volts, VT is 4 volts, and VGS is 8. Okay, so we know that, so we have to first, so we have to determine the drain current. Okay, so what is the expression for drain current? Drain current is K into VGS on minus VT whole square, right? So, and you can calculate K. So K is found by the expression for to find K is ID divided by ID on. ID on is known, VGS on is known, VT is also known. Okay, so using that we can calculate K. So K is equal to ID on divided by VGS on minus VT whole square. So substituting the values here, you get K to be 1 into 10 power minus 3 A by V square. And so substituting for VGS on and VT here and K value, you get the drain current to be 16 milliamps. Okay. Next, we'll move on to the second problem. So for a depletion type MOSFET, determine ID if VGS is minus 1 volt and VP is minus 4 volts and IDSS is 16 milliamp. Okay, so the relation, so we have to find the drain current. So VGS is given, VP is given, IDSS is given. So we can calculate ID using this formula. So where ID is given by IDSS into 1 minus VGS by VP whole square. So ID is equal to 16 into 1 minus minus 1 by minus 4 whole square. So where the drain current is 9 milliamps. Yeah, so here again, for a depletion type MOSFET, determine the value of VP now. If VGS is 1 minus 1 volt, ID is 8 milliohm and IDS is 12 milliohm. Okay, so now we have to find the VP, pinch off voltage. Okay, so how so using the same expression, ID is equal to IDS is 1 minus VGS by VP whole square. Substituting the value for drain current, VGS voltage and IDS, you get VP is equal to 1 over root of 8 by 12 minus 1, which is equal to minus 5.45 volts. Okay. The next problem is for a E-MOSFET, determine the value of VT. If K is equal to 1 milliamp per volt square and ID is equal to 4 milliamp, VGS is 5 volt. Okay. So we know the expression for K here, and also we know how to relate K with VT. Okay, so VT is nothing but VGS on minus ID on by K. Okay, so calculating the value of K here, you can substitute VT is equal to 5 minus root of 4 by 1, that is equal to 3 volt. Okay, and so we will stop here with our discussion on the small signal. We'll continue in the next session. Thank you.